So without wasting our time, let me start with the next nakshatra that we are going to deal, and that is Adra. Adra. In this class, what we will be doing, we will look at the nakshatra mantra of Adra, the stories of Adra, the remedies of Adra, and the result of different padas of Adra. Right? Adra, by nature, means moist. Moist or wet, whatever you say. Right? Either you say it is a moist nakshatra or you say it is a wet nakshatra. Both of them are okay. Some people take it as wet. Some people take it as moist. Adra, the word basically in Sanskrit will mean moist only. And you know, there is one very prominent thing with this being moist. Water indicates emotion. Okay. When you are very happy, tears start coming out of your eyes. When you are very sad, tears start coming out of your eyes. That is water. And water is related to emotion. And Adra is related to flux of emotion. Adra person will take many decisions in their life based on emotion only. Major decisions of their life will be based on emotion. Getting my point? And there is one very prominent thing. One day, this emotion evaporates. That is a trend with Adra. Let me be very honest. So that is the trend with Adra. Adra is emotionally motivated. They will do multiple things in their life based on emotions. And one day their emotion will dry up. Because it is moist, right? It will dry up. And that drying up forces them to back out from things. That is a very peculiar trait. And that is a very important thing. So first advice to Adra people that I will give is not to take decisions based on emotion. Getting my point? Like if the 10th Lord is in Adra. You wanted to do some work, you will start working. Because you feel connected to that work. But one day, your connection to that particular thing you will lose. And that day, your profession will stop making any sense to you. You will not want to continue your profession. You will not want to pursue your profession. And generally, such people will leave all their complete setup, will ignore all the investments that they have made in business and will stop doing the business. Getting my point? That's a trend. Going further, you know what Adra is signified by? Diamond. These people, so what is so about diamond? Have three things. Diamond have multiple edges. Adra indicates someone who is proficient in everything. He is proficient in all the four things of dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Adra indicates someone being well proficient. He is someone who is very good in worship, who is very good in sexuality, who is very good in money making. He is very good in everything. He is well versed in everything. Right? A multifaceted personality, someone who is an all-rounder, is indicated by Adra. Another thing very famous, we all know that diamond is coal put under extreme pressure. Such people, you know, Adra people, sometime or other in their life have to go through extreme pressure. They have to be extremely courageous. Imagine it, like a woman with a 2-month-old child whose husband have recently died and she have no one to rely upon. That is what Adra is. She will start crying and her tears will dry up. And then she will stand to take firm decision in their life. She will take the stand to become a stronger woman. That is what is indicated by Adra. Being pushed into circumstances which are not very favorable, being pushed to become courageous, being pushed to become a warrior, being pushed to become a fighter. That is indicated by the diamond of Adra. Along with this, you know, Adra people or planet in Adra is not easily influenced. It is very difficult to change the karma of Adra. If the seventh lord is in Adra and if the person is having a good marital life, it will continue to remain good despite all the bad circumstances in marriage. Whereas if the seventh lord is in Adra and the relationship is bad, in that scenario, the relationship will continue to be bad despite lessons in life. The lessons of life, the advice of people, the loss, the gain, doesn't affect the core nature of Adra. Adra is very much like an umbrella. Water falls over it, but will not make any change to it. No advice, no realization can make a change in Adra. They are the way they are. Right? This rigidity complex is there in Adra always. Understood? In classes from now onwards, I will try to become non-repetitive. So I will say something in nutshell, understand it in a wider perspective. Coming to this particular part of if the seventh lord is in Adra and if the marital life is bad, how to decide that? Once again, if a malefic planet is in the nakshatra goes bad. If a benefic planet is in nakshatra, the nakshatra is good, right? So if the seventh lord is a bad planet who is in Adra, you are going to have bad traits of Adra. When the seventh lord is a good planet in Adra, you are going to have good traits of Adra. Understand it in this way. Getting my point? Adra is very much into relationships. Relationships in their life are very prominent. And more than prominent, the relationship is very contagious. Over the time, they change to become like their spouse. They change to become like their boyfriends. There is only one person who can make change in their life. There is only one person who can induce change in their life, and that is their own spouse. Along with that, Adra people are very good in writing and communication. Their sense of understanding is far superior, and generally, Adra indicates quick rise to fame, quick rise to the top position. Generally, Adra is praised by everyone, and the Adra person is so clever to be appreciated, right? He is very much clever that he cannot be completely appreciated. Understood my point? And you know what, there is one very prominent trait with Adra. You cannot ignore Adra. Right. So if the third lord is in Adra, you cannot ignore the writing of this person. For an example, Nathuram Godse wrote about Mahatma Gandhi, right? Nathuram Godse wrote about Mahatma Gandhi, why I killed Mahatma. And the lust to read his book is so high that you cannot ignore reading his book, right? That is what is in Adra. Adra can be good, Adra can be bad, but you cannot ignore that. So if the seventh lord is in Adra, maybe that is a very bad person. But still you cannot resist the temptation to interact with that person. You cannot resist the temptation of getting in relationship with that person. Even at least for 1 minute, for 1 second, you will have the temptation to interact with that person or get in relationship with that person. If the fifth lord is in Adra, then you will for sure get attracted to their teachings. you will for sure get attracted to their way of understanding. Do you get my point? This is what is indicated by Adra. Right? And but as I told you, Adra is evaporation. Adra is drying up. So your fascination towards Adra will never end. But Adra's fascination towards you, Adra's liking towards you will dry up. So for an example, if someone is having the fifth lord in Adra, their writings are very good. And you cannot escape their writing. You cannot escape their ideas. You have to support their ideas. You have to support what they are saying. But one day suddenly they will stop writing. One day suddenly they will stop publishing because their interest in writing will evaporate. Right? This is what I told you. So understand it in a wider perspective. All the words, note it down, write it in a copy and read it as a story. Right? Read it as a framework of how Adra works. Got my point? Going further, the Lord of Adra is Rudra. The Lord of Adra is Rudra. And what does Rudra do? What do you think? What does Rudra do? Rudra, how many of you know that Rudra indicates crying? Right, Rudra indicates crying, but why Rudra is crying? That is an important question to ask. Rudra, Lord Adra, and Rudra means crying. Rudra is crying, but why Rudra is crying? Rudra is crying for the welfare of world. Rain is needed for harvest to grow. And sometimes it will not rain. So Rudra will come on the earth and will start crying from the earth. He will send strong vibrations. He cries very loud. He will send strong vibrations to the clouds so that they will tremble and start raining. That is indicated by Adra. So you know what? Adra is a crying child. But they cry for the welfare. So you see that protester, right? You see that male person protesting for woman rights. You see that woman protesting for the male rights. You see the young person protesting for the old people's right. You see the old person protesting for the child, save child. That is Adra. They are crying, they will create a nuisance for the welfare. For an example, Yogi Adityanath. So despite being a yogi, he's into politics because he wants to change something, right? Raj Yogi. Raj Yogis are indicated by Adra. They are crying, they are constantly working for the welfare of the world. And this welfare of the world, welfare of the society, welfare of everyone is the theme of Adra. That is the prime thing of Adra. Rudra destroys. Why Rudra destroys? So that the world doesn't become overpopulated. Right? Because if people keep on living, the world will be overpopulated. There will be an unnecessary disbalance in power. So Rudra kills to create the balance. Adra is very much related to NGO. Adra is very much related to works of public interest. Adra is very much related to working for someone else's benefit. Getting my point? That is the theme of Adra. Standing for someone else, speaking for someone else, that is the theme of Adra. So when the fifth lord is in Adra, you can be a very good person. You can start, So suppose if the fifth lord is in Adra, then the person is very much probable to help people get children.
Popat Rao or Yogi.
So they can be in IVF industry. or you know they can be giving their voluntary services to couples produce child or have child, right? So they can be adoption services, IVF services, or they can be gynecologist, gynae, etc. You know, the surrogacy, they can be in surrogacy. Getting my point? Working for the welfare of the society. Adra is very much related to giving things for free, giving things just for the benefit of the world. When the third lord is in Adra, when the fifth lord is in Adra, people is very much into giving free advices to people for their welfare, for their benefit. And there also comes a remedy for Adra. If there is a problem related to Adra, try giving money or your services for the welfare of the world, right? So if you are an astrologer and you have prominent planets in Adra, in that scenario, try giving your services for free to the society, for the welfare of the society. Right? Try giving your services for free, at least to a select people. Specifically because Adra falls in Gemini, try doing it on Wednesday. Achha, let me tell you one particular. Why you have holiday on Sunday? Because everyone is supposed to worship the sun god. Sun god is in every religion. Because sun you can see from your naked eyes. Vishnu you cannot see, sun you can see, right? So whichever planet is most powerful in your horoscope, have a holiday on that particular day. Specifically on the day of the 10th lord, you should have a holiday. 10th lord is working constantly throughout your life. At least give him rest for one day. Right? So 10th lord day, see, anyone who takes, you know, there's a very famous doctor in the Dehradun. And, you know, in his office, like people sit in chairs waiting for their turn. He will give appointment. He will give tokens. Even if he gives you a token for 11:30, you will get your turn at 2:30. So much of, it's very famous. He was quite an old person, some 75, 76 years old doctor. Right? And his clinic is closed on Thursday. He is born in Gemini ascendant. Closed on Thursday, right? The 10th lord is Jupiter. When the Lagna lord is in Adra, in that scenario, the person should give free advices for the, you know, personality development of people. Or, you know, Lagna is improvement as a person. So if the Lagna lord is in Adra, you should give free advice to people for their benefit. Free advice to people to keep their mind calm. They should work as a social counselor. Right? When the Lagna lord is in Adra, work as a social counselor, try giving free advice to people for their personality development, free advice to people for calming their mind, right? So try giving psychological consultation to people if the Lagna lord is in Adra, right? Going further, you know, Adra indicates hands. So Adra is not someone who just want to talk, who will just talk to change the world. Adra is someone who will really go and do it. Adra is a person who works more on implementation rather than thinking. So, you know, when the seventh lord is in Adra, it doesn't matter that the person will succeed in relationship or not, but at least he will try for a multitude of relationships, right? Adra indicates hands. And, you know, working, doing something is very prominent with Adra. So in the case, suppose once again, take Lagna lord. If the Lagna lord is in Adra, in that scenario, it is a kind of a person who will not try to say something to someone else. He will be the one who will go and do the thing himself. Right? Adra indicate hands. And so this is a person who is more a believer in work to change it. So he is not someone who will advise you that you can do it. He will start doing it. He will succeed and then he will tell, see, if I can do, you can also. You do. Right? So Adra is led by example. Right? Adra is led by example. That is what Adra does. And you know what? Adra is brutal. Adra indicates one part, you know, one part. is brutally chopped. For Agra, you know, like whichever planet is in Agra, based on the signification of that planet, one part is chopped off. For an example, if the sun is in Agra, the authority, power, the father, without any reason, very cruelly, is not present in your life. And if the moon is in Agra, then emotional support, mother, is, you know, like very harshly taken away from your life. Is what it is supposed to indicate. If the seventh lord is in Agra, then one of your relationship ends very bad. You know, a very bad sore experience. Sore mane kadava. S-O-R-E. A very bad sore experience is indicated by Agra. Whenever I will use a difficult word whose pronunciation I think is, I am making a wrong pronunciation in English, I will try to tell the Hindi also the particular word. Okay. Getting my point? So it is an indicative of a sore experience, a bitter experience is indicated by Agra. And you know, Agra is very much like, you know, unexplained things. Agra doesn't explain things. Something happened and you don't know why. Agra is engulfed in secrecy. Right? Someone started crying. You are talking to someone and he started crying. Now you don't know which word actually hit the person. So you will guess this word hit you. You found is baat se hurt ho gaya kya. You found this thing bad. You found that thing bad. But you are not actually able to identify what went wrong. That is what is indicated by Agra. Along with this, Agra also have deer tendency. Right? Agra have deer tendency. Right? So Agra tries to jump on things. Despite this person being a perfectionist who want to do everything by himself, who want to lead by example. Right? Who wants to lead by example. It is a person who will not be able to hold everything at once. Right? He will not be able to, you know, deer indicates this particular tendency. And this is also the tendency of moon, that only one thing can be good at one particular point of time. If the mind is very good, then the person is in high level of intoxication. Right? So despite his mind and mentality being very good, his own behavior, his own understanding of himself is not very good, right? So only one part is good, another part is bad. Right? That is something that is indicated by the deer tendency. Right? Along with this, you know, this Agra always wants to support the person. And you know, this Agra is a very good father. Agra is a very good guardian. They are very much focused on the growth of the people under them. They are very good parents. They are strongly, they will strongly think of the welfare of their child. Right? You know, even employees under Agra. Agra as a boss is very caring about their employees. He actually wants good for all. Because Agra indicates the growth of grains, the growth of grass. Right? So Agra as a parent, Agra as a superior, will always want you to grow. Really will want you to grow. Right? It will not be the one who will, like, you know, so telling it in a different word, in a different sentence, Agra is someone who is really concerned with growth. He is not just doing a lip service. If Agra is giving you a good advice, it is not because they want to advise. It is because they really want you to change. They really want you to grow. Whatever an Agra does to you is for your benefit only. You know, this drying up of Agra that I told you, that Agra will lose emotions one day. They will not lose emotions because they don't want to interact with you or, you know, their work is done with you. They will lose emotions because they think that being with them is not good for you. So whatever decisions an Agra will take will be based on your betterment, not Agra's betterment. Right? Okay. So, you know, Agra, the Lord Rudra is the Lord of Thunder. Rudra is the Lord of Thunder. Right? And whenever thunder falls on something, it cuts that thing into half. Right? That is indicated by Adra. The flare of Adra, as I told you, Adra also indicates incomplete growth, you know, something being torn away. Right? So first of all, Adra is very much, Adra is very much cruel towards themselves, right? So they are very good for the world, but they are very cruel for themselves, right? Adra is lightning. And you know, when a lightning falls on a tree, the tree will be chopped into half. And so Adra is very cruel for themselves. Adra indicates cruel deeds. Right, Pratulji?
Yeah, bilkul sir.
Yeah, Adra. Yes, this, you know, the suicidal tendency is something that comes with Adra also. Suicidal tendency comes with Adra. Why? You think why suicidal tendency comes with Adra? I said, this is the question for the particular thing. If you find the answer, comment it. Why Adra wants to commit suicide?
So you just told that Adra is very much cruel for themselves. I think that answered that question.
You know, Adra is like a demon. There is a demon is told in the classics. There is a demon who had the power to turn everything into gold. Right? Demon or king, whatever you say, there was a king who had the power to turn everything into gold. Or there was a demon who had the power to turn everything into ashes, burn everything. Whatever thing he touched, he had the power to burn it. So people went to Shiva to take refuge from this particular demon because the demon was disturbing them. So Shiva started teaching him dance. And in the dance, Shiva puts his hand over head. So the demon also did, and he himself burned. That is indicated by Adra. So Adra have all the power to do good. Whatever Adra touches turns into gold. And when he keeps hand on his own head, he himself will turn into gold. That makes him mobile, right? There's a story of a king who had the power to turn everything into gold, and that king was very sad. Why that king was very sad? Because he never got the chance to touch their own children. Because if he touched his children, they also turn into gold. Turning into gold means what? They will die. They will not be able to move. They will not be able to play, right? So the boon of Adra is a bane for Adra itself, right? That's why it is crying. The boon for whatever Adra achieved after this much hard work is something that will haunt Adra very badly. That's a trend with Adra.
So can I give a small example? Albert Einstein ka chart tha. तो अल्बर्ट आइंस्टीन का आद्रा नक्षत्र है, तो उसके ना लास्ट वर्ड्स क्या थे जब उसने एटम बॉम्ब के लिए थोड़ा अपना योगदान दिया था? तो उसने बोला था, आई नेवर थॉट कि आई विल क्रिएट अ सच अ हीनियस थिंग जो इतने लोगों की जान ले लेगा. सो उसने सोचा तो इन्वेंशन था, बट उसने एक डिस्ट्रक्शन का वेपन तैयार कर दिया.
Yes, yes, yes. And if you go to the previous nakshatras, I think we have covered one more nakshatra where I have explained why Adolf Hitler gives this particular statement. That is also signified by one more nakshatra. So you know the traits of, when you read nakshatras, the traits are very much repetitive. Then, so you know, you take the nakshatras of all the planets and ascendant, and you take the common thread between all the nakshatras, and that thing is very particular, that thing is very peculiar. You are very right, Pratul. Because of the lagna of Albert Einstein being in Adra, he had the blessings of physics. But that became the bane for himself. That it created so much destruction for the world. Really, he wanted to do good for the world, right? He created the atom thing so that the whole world can get free electricity kind of stuff. The whole world can get free power. He did this because he was against the use of natural resources for the production of power. So he wanted to give a synthetic resource for power. Otherwise, coal is burning, petrol is being mined out, the earth is not in a good condition, right? ग्लोबल वार्मिंग इज इंक्रीजिंग, प्राकृतिक शक्तियों का दोहन हो रहा है ना मी. एंड यू नो व्हाट, देयर इज वन पर्टिकुलर थिंग विद अद्रा. अद्रा इंडिकेट्स हंटिंग एंड गैदरिंग, राइट? सो डिस्पाइट अद्रा बीइंग गुड फॉर ऑल, डिस्पाइट अद्रा बीइंग सपोर्टिव टू ऑल, डिस्पाइट अद्रा वांटिंग एवरीवन्स ग्रोथ, फॉर अद्रा, as I told you before also, for Adra, they have to do everything for themselves, right? They have to dig their well, take the water out and drink it. There is no one who helps Adra. Adra always have to start from ground zero. Despite Adra being born in a good family, despite Adra being born in a rich family, they have to work their way up to the top. They have to work their way for everything. Adra unnecessarily have a very difficult life because they will have to start from scratch. They will have to start from level zero. They will have to start from ground zero. Right? So seventh lord in Adra, despite having a very beautiful face, despite having a very charming personality, you will have to work very hard. You will have to struggle to get a spouse. Right? Tenth lord in Adra, despite being well qualified, despite being well learned, you will have to struggle very hard to get a job, to secure a job, to get your position to the top. That is also indicated by Adra. Right? Adra is generally not very, stone hearted. Adra is very delicate in the emotions, specifically at the heart level. Adra is very delicate. I will give you a particular advice here. Adra person should never be delicate. Adra person should never be emotionally oriented. Adra person should always be a bit stone-hearted. Adra indicates melting away, right? So Adra have a tendency to lose themselves into things. When Adra loves someone, they love wholeheartedly. When they are dedicated towards someone, they are dedicated wholeheartedly. And this is something that they should not do. Specifically, Adra woman should not be doing this particular thing. Don't see, let me tell you one very particular thing. You have power in yourself. Do you realize it? You are a soul, I am a soul. We have same amount of power, right? Don't melt away very easily. Don't give recognition to anyone very easily. Don't give devotion to anyone very easily. That is the lesson of Adra, and that is what I want to tell all of you. Don't give anything very easily. Getting my point? So melting away, Adra means melting. And these people devote themselves to something very easily. If the ninth lord is in Adra, you devote yourself to your guru very easily. If the seventh lord is in Adra, you devote yourself to your spouse very easily. And that is something that you should not be doing. Be a bit stone-hearted, be a bit mean, otherwise you can be misused. That particular signification of your life can be misused. So this Adra people should pay attention that they are not easily molded away, and not only Adra, every one of you should pay attention. You know, so see, this is the problem with human life. You are like, the politicians are bad. You chose them. So, we all of us choose someone over us. And whom you choose, be very careful about that particular thing. Do you feel cheated and rejected? Sir, I spend my money reading with this teacher. I learned nothing. Sir, I have saved so money. I take admission in XYZ course. And I learned nothing. You know why you got cheated? Because you gave your devotion to that particular person without testing, without taking time. You know what? You got influenced by the social media post. You got influenced by the lie that the person is saying. Swami Vivekanand, before taking Ramakrishna Paramahansa as his guru, tested him multiple times. He heard that Ramakrishna never touched woman in gold. So he put few coins inside the bed of Ramakrishna Paramahansa, and when Ramakrishna sat on the bed, his body started burning. Whichever parts the coin touched him, that part had burn marks, and he was not able to sit on the bed. So he went up. Some other person came and removed the coins from the bed. He went to Ganga and take a bath in the Ganga. The bed was washed in Ganga and then he was able to sit on it. Vivekananda tested Ramakrishna Paramahansa for 4 years before taking him as guru. And you take anyone as guru like anything. That is the reason why you get cheated. That is the reason your hard-earned money is not with you. Because you don't test. Understand something. You have the power to make. You as people, we as people, I as a person have the power to make something. Always, we all as a person create society. You know about the Sikh gurus, right? They are humans, but they are worshipped. You know why? Because they never gave up. They never gave up. Getting my point? Everyone was obeying Englishmen. But they, you read about the Sikh gurus, right? Some one of them is buried in the wall, some of them cut in the half, but they never gave up. Understand, you are the power. And when you take someone as your guru, when you take someone as your superior, you give them your power. You are the power. You give your devotion to them, they get the power. And then they can misuse the power, right? So test the person 1,000 times before giving him anything. It is told in Chanakya Niti that before you give donation to a beggar, test the beggar. Right? If he is a greedy beggar, don't give him any money or don't give him anything. So that is the lesson of Agra. For Agra people, it is very prominent, but it is also prominent for all of us as a society. Because Agra is the first nakshatra that is ruled by Rahu in Vimshottari Dasha, right? And Rahu is Kali Yuga. So this is how, getting my point. The real guru will never have that much following as the fake guru will have. That have always been the trend since the starting. You go to Dasara right now, there are very few Ram supporters and many Ravan supporters. In Dasara nowadays, right? People want to become like Ravan. If there was any Brahman that was like Ravan, that means you allow someone to kidnap your wife. Think over it. However, going further, coming to stories of Agra. As I told you, Agra is ruled by Shiva. And Shiva drinks poison for the welfare of the world. So the person takes many things on him for the welfare of the world, specifically for the welfare of their family. They generally take problem on themselves for the welfare of their family. Agra indicates someone who became mature before time. Agra indicates someone who is mature since their birth. Getting my point? Drinking the poison for the... So, you know, Agra is very volatile for getting exploited. Because they will want to take problems on themselves. Agra people are the people who are harassed in childhood, etc. Because they want to take things on themselves. Getting my point? When they will find that someone is going to beat their friend, they will say, you rather beat me, not my friend. And this is the biggest problem with Agra. They want to take things on themselves that they should not be doing. Right? And you know, Agra indicates great knowledge. Agra can even advise the greatest of teachers. See, why I listen to Abhilasa, you know? Because she have her moon in Agra. Shiva is the one who gives advice to Brahma. Right? Agra means someone who gives advice to Brahma. Right? So, you know, this Agra person can always give you, even if you are the master of your subject, this Agra person can give you an advice which is valuable more than gold for you. Getting my point? So, always listen to an Agra. Ignore Shravan. Listen to Agra. Agra is important. Okay? Right. Agra is loved by all. Agra is supported by all. Gets easy fame. Right? And your relationship with Adra, you know, despite the fact that Adra will want to keep you away from all the trouble, generally, unknowingly, Adra creates trouble in everyone's life. And at least once in life, people suffer because of Adra. And Adra realizes this particular fact. And only for this reason, he is very much devoted to not hurt people in contact with him in any way. Right? As I told you, Adra is very philanthropic. And he is, Adra is generally very much given to philanthropy. Adra thinks good for everyone, as I already told. Right? This is the trend for Adra. Right? Generally, let me tell you one particular thing. I am taking the nakshatra mantras from some Brahman. And you know why I think that my interpretation is right? Ask me why. I am taking a mantra from Brahman. I know Sanskrit well. I have translated the mantra. And I explain you the mantras. Then I go to the section where I have written stories, handwritten in my notebook, right? And when I read the stories, I surprisingly find in every class, now this is one more class, I surprisingly find in every class that whatever is written in the story is something that I have already explained in the mantra. Right? So now whatever is told in the story is once again the same. Right? So that's it for the general things of Adra. Now we will go to the remedies for Adra and result of different padas in Adra. Right? About Adra, I will be giving you three remedies. First of all, as I told you, Adra is ruled by Rudra. Chanting the Rudra Gayatri, Tat Purushaya Vidmahe Mahadevaya Dhimahi Tanno Rudra Prachodayat is very, very beneficial, point one. Right. Also, one more thing is that there is a mantra karchalan kritam vak kayajam karbhajam vasravan nenajamama van samva pratam vihitam vihitam vasravam vidachchamasu jay jay karanaapte shri mahadev shambho. This shloka is to seek forgiveness from Lord Shiva. One of the mantra you should be doing at least every day. This karchalan kritam vak kayajam karbhajam va. This mantra you remember and have a habit to do it every time. At least three, four times a day. At when you wake up, in the afternoon, in the evening, and before you sleep. Getting my point? Also, remedies related to Shiva is very beneficial. Specifically, Shiv Tandav Stotram is highly recommended. Right? Shiv Tandav, because Adra indicates the Tandav of Shiva, the fierce dancing of Shiva for creation and dissolution and destruction, point one. Point two, people born in Adra should pour water to Shivalinga almost daily, because Adra indicates the poison drinking part of Shiva, right? So to keep his throat cold, they should do it. And one particular thing, one very particular thing. If you are an Adra person, try having a tikka on your throat, right? So some people, when they do worship, they put a tikka on their throat, right now in this particular area. So try having a tikka on your throat. And whenever you are going to like put tikka anywhere on your body, either on head or on the throat, always use the sun finger, not this particular finger. Don't use the first two fingers. Use this particular finger, right? Coming to the padas of Adra. The first pada of Adra is, like talking about the first pada of Adra, that the first pada of Adra indicates someone who is scholarly oriented. It is a type of a person who is, you know, very much well-versed into, you know, he's very well-versed into reading, writing, understanding. Someone who is intelligent. Generally into a reading, writing profession as well. Right. And someone who is into reading, writing as well. The person is good into speaking, very good with finances, generally engaged in business. Someone who is a bit fat and childlike. They will have delay in childbirth and delay in like their siblings, and they will have quite difference in age. They will be, and generally a progeny comes with problems. Right, the peace in family will not be there. Right, over the time they will have obesity, their weight will increase. Right, these people are very unconventional. They generally, even if they are Brahmins or even they belong to a very strong religious family, their own views will be quite liberal. Right, they will support freedom of people. Along with that, you know, it is they are liberal. But at the same point of time, they know how to support the dharma. So they are very much dedicated toward the core values of the dharma, but bit liberal with things also. Generally, their approach is to propagate the real understanding and real crux of the particular thing, rather than just, paying a lip service to that particular stuff. Finances are good. They are engaged in business, as I have already told you, right? Generally, they have no diseases, but strong opposition. Their marital life is good. Spouse is talented as well as devoted, right? Longevity is also good. And generally, they get money from heredity, like paternal property as well. Their luck supports them, right? In their profession, before they achieve the age of 28, 29, there will be instability. After 28, 29, there will be some stability in the work. If they are into business, very good. If they are not into business, then they will have to switch to business either ways. Right? They will be fair in complexion. They can be addicted to alcohol or something. Right? Otherwise, they will have problems related to eyes, which will lead to redness in eyes, rather be it skin-related problem or allergy-related problem. Right? They will have beautiful and well-built nose. Their body will be well-built, very proportionate. They will be intelligent. Their face will be a bit long. Their eyes will be dark. Their eyebrows will be very prominent. And they will be very good in speaking, as I have already told you, right? The first pada of Adra. The second pada of Adra is a hard worker, right? Difficult to get recognition. Generally, the success in life comes after 30 to 33. Before 32 and 33, there is strong struggle, right? These people, Agra second pada, is unnecessarily laden with responsibilities. And, you know, like responsibilities, they are a magnet for responsibilities, right? The effect of aging is very prominent on them. The effect of aging is very visibly seen on their body. Generally, dark circle around the eyes and black patches all over the body is what is very prominent. They are generally tall. If not tall, then at least, you know, from like when looked at from a distance, they look tall, right? They are someone who will not have very strong influx of money, but they will be someone very much, devoted to collecting money in small amounts to fulfill their wishes and desires. Generally, their life is filled up with disappointments, whichever thing they will invest their time and money on. There will be at least one disappointment related to that particular area in life, right? In siblings, they will generally have sisters, right? They will have their own home late in life. If they have their home in the starting part of life, then they are not able to live peacefully in that home. Vehicle or convenience is generally not in their life. Even if the vehicle and convenience is there, then it will be creating troubles for them. Right, they are not very good in speaking. People generally misunderstand them. Related to children, they will have female children, and children will come with a delay, or they themselves will practice self-control and will do proper family planning and will not have children very easily or very quickly. Right, they will be troubled by diseases as well as enemies. There will be multiple obstacles and obstructions in life. The age difference between them and their partner can be huge. Their partner, despite being skillful, will be very much platonic, वेरी मच गिवन टू डिसअपॉइंटमेंट्स, नॉट वेरी क्रेजियस पर्सन, देयर स्पाउस इज जनरली अ वेरी डल पर्सनैलिटी राइट, बट स्किलफुल एंड डिवोटेड टू द नेटिव राइट, दे जनरली हैव अ लॉन्ग लाइफ एंड देयर लक इज हाईली फ्लक्चुएटिंग, समटाइम्स दे विल हैव वेरी गुड लक एंड समटाइम्स दे विल हैव वेरी बैड लक. Specifically telling you, it indicates a very strong, very strong impression of past things on the person, right? So if they have lost a job, that impression of that I have lost a job will be very, very prominent on their minds. It will be problematic, right? Coming to the third pada of Adra, the person is fat. Like the third pada of Adra, the person is fat. He will gain a whole lot of weight. The person is very intelligent, very knowledgeable. But most importantly, this is Hanuman. Adra third pada is Hanuman. He don't know his capabilities, right? People will not underestimate him. He himself will underestimate himself, right? This is generally a person who is a storehouse of emotions, but will not let the emotions come out, right? You should also read it with respect to planets. Okay, so if the fifth lord is in the like Adra third pada, then the person is a storehouse of knowledge, but will not let the knowledge come out. He will keep the knowledge inside himself, right? Like tenth lord in Adra third pada, the person is very skilled in working, but he will not show his skill in day to day life. When he is challenged that he cannot achieve something in his profession, only then his Hanuman will come out. Otherwise, he will be very dormant, right? So you should understand with respect to planets and with respect to ascendant, both of the things, right? I'm not explaining it in that particular way, right? Okay. Going further, they are quite fortunate. They have good children, first of all. And good results related to their children is also there. Right, so children are obedient. They will generally have late children. Female child that too late, but children will be obedient. And after the birth of child, there will be a rise in fortune. They will be able to save money and they will be rich as well. Right, but that money comes after a lot of struggles. Their life is one good thing will happen and then good thing will keep on happening again and again. But for that particular good thing to happen, they will have to go through Agni Pariksha every time. Unnecessary burden and unnecessarily sore and bad experiences is very evident with the third pada of Adra. Generally female siblings, children are both male and female, but prominently female, right? They will have home quite early in life. Right, they will have home and vehicle quite early in life, and the happiness from home and vehicle is also good. Generally, they maintain a good health, but they will be prone to infections, to particular things, right? And that infection will lead them to trouble. Generally, there are no enemies or no competition. If there are enemies and competition, it is just because of this person's negligence and him not understanding his own potential. Once he comes to his own form, once he realizes his potential, there is no one to compete with him, right? There is generally an age difference between the spouse. Spouse is good, but henpecked, jono ka gulam jisko apan Hindi mein kehte hain, right? Henpecked, devoted to the spouse, right? Spouse is devoted to the native. Technically, should be told in this particular way, right? Their marital life is good, provided the fact that it is. A marriage of compromises. If it is a marriage of compromises, it is good. If it is a purely love marriage or purely arranged marriage, then it is not good. Then it should be a marriage of compromise for it to be good. Longevity is good, luck is good, person is fortunate, is what I will say. Right. Generally, the person will have a broad face, a strong chest, prominent chest, big head. He will be prone to mischief. He will always think on different ways to disturb people. Right, and he will be cunning, and he will be like, he will be charming, he will be attractive, and he will be like, he will be a friend to many people and advisor to many people for the third pada of Adra. Right, I forgot to tell you the bodily characters for the second pada of Adra, so I will tell. The second pada of Adra person will have a prominent forehead and much hair on their eyebrows. They will be lustful. The second pada of Adra is lustful as well as frustrated. Their body will be like quite broad. Their body will be square. So the height and breadth proportion is almost similar. But still, even in that case, they look taller as compared to the body mass or body fat. Right? They will be broad-chested, right? Their chest will be broad. Their teeth will be white and shiny. They will be soft in speech and will have very attractive and good hair. Generally blessed with hair, right? That was the physique for the Adra second pada and result for the Adra third pada we have already covered. Adra fourth pada is one of the worst padas to be born into. Right? Life is full of cheating. The person is highly emotional and devoted to everyone, and everyone who comes in their life only cheats them. Right? So it is full of cheating. Health is weak. There are many enemies. There are multiple oppositions. They are blessed with respect to fortune. So they will become fortunate. They will have the support of fortune. In their profession also, they will be blessed. In money matters also, they will make good money, but will not be able to save money. For their day-to-day expenses, they will have enough money. And they will never fall short of in terms of money when it comes to fulfilling their desire and getting the things that is necessary for their life. But for saving the money, and making property or making vehicle, this is not a very favorable position, right? Lucky they are, but at the same point of time, they will have problem with diseases, weak health. Added to that, there will be very strong oppositions in life, right? Siblings and children will be a mix of male and female. So both male and female child, both male and female siblings. But relationship with sibling will be difficult and child will come after struggle and after doing remedies. Right? Relationship with family member is almost good and jovial, but in the time of despair, in the time of need, family members will be of no use. Generally, such people have the happiness of home, but cannot live in their home peacefully. Only in rented property, they will be able to live peacefully. In their own home, there will be multiple problems related to home only, and they will not be able to live peacefully there. Like the spouse is good, charming, a bit fat, devoted, skillful. And the spouse is more devoted to their work than to the relationship, right? So their office is office, home is also a kind of mini office, right? For the people in the Adra fourth pada. And the people of Adra fourth pada will have yellowish eyes. That is a sign of weakness, as well as a sign of someone who is getting lack of sleep, right? They will be like easily frustrated and prone to anger. Along with that, their face will be broad. Right, specifically the cheek area will be broad, and their body will not be well proportioned. So weak legs, strong chest, or weak chest, strong legs, that kind of scenario will be there. Their lips will be very beautiful, right? And they will not be devoted to anything. They will be quite rebellious. They will not trust on people easily. They will not trust on things easily. And even if they trust, they are someone who will be a rogue, right? He will like, finally in the end, he will go against everything that he have learned and believed over the years. And he will be fickle-minded. He will be strong. And moon, the problem related to moon, right? Fluctuations in emotions, fluctuations in mental peace, fluctuations in mental thought, sometime thinking of doing this, sometime thinking of doing that, etc., is their main problem. Right, telling you about the remedies. Adra first pada, should do panchakshari namah shivaya mantra. Right, Adra second pada should person should do sip panchakshar stotram. Adra third pada should worship Agastya Muni. right? Have an image of Agastya Muni and worship Agastya Muni, like worship it as your forefather. And Agra, fourth pada, at least once in a year visit to a tirth, visit to a religious place and stay at that religious place for at least 4 days and donate something at that religious place for the Agra fourth pada. Okay. Now, the activation years of Agra because of someone's request. See, there are 2-3 activation periods for Agra. There are 2-3 activation periods for every planet. Right. So I will tell you. Agra will get activated at the first year of age. Right. Agra will get activated at the 55th year of age. Right. Agra will get activated at the 19th year of age. And Agra will get activated at the 32nd year of age. Okay. If you come to the course, in the course, I have taught a particularly separate dasha to time events based on the activation of the nakshatras. Right. So for course people who are in the course, I will further recommend you to go with the dasha rather than going with this particular activation band of years. Right. For those who are watching the video on YouTube, I will request you to try decoding the years. And if you successfully decode it, then who knows which way you can get rewarded, right? Thank you for watching the video. Namaskar.